Right, chaps, the hot topic for today is line colour. Do you think it matters?
For me, I'm a big believer it does. I've fished a few waters, some French waters as well, pressured as well, some of them. And I've got three rods out, and the two that were green, I'm definitely getting more takes on. And swap them around, you know, I mean, sometimes you think, well, they're all clipped up the same distance. If one goes to the left of the marker, obviously, you know, you swap them around, they'll fish at the same distance. Grenville, same thing. Green, for me, was outproducing it clear.
Clear?
Yeah. Right, I was really, okay. Really shocked.
Yeah.
I didn't think it would have made any difference. But definitely, I mean, it was being witnessed by other people for me, but that's on the waters I'm fishing. You might have gone a different water. And
do you think the light's reflecting off the clear somehow and doing something?
I don't really, I would like to say, I thought sure. Perhaps what was happening with the green, perhaps it sounds crazy, but perhaps the green is, because it's more of a weird colour, if it was getting particles on it, it probably wasn't sticking out so much, but
right,
and I thought, is it because it's over a few, I mean, some of these were out 24 hours, I was getting the takes, only thing is you did find is the clear is a lot more abrasion resistant, stronger,
right,
and so forth, so there's that, there's opinion you've got to look at as well, but, definitely, it seems to be too much for me on the waters I'm fishing. I'm catching them fish more and more on the green line.
Right. Well, so, what about you, Dave? What do you think?
Well, in my own personal fishing, I use about 30-40 foot of fluorocarbon as a leader where I can. So to me, my spool line, my reel line, doesn't really. I'm not really that bothered about the colour. I've experienced. In my own fishing, all the molecules in the water are sticking to the line anyway.
Yeah.
And most of the time, the stuff which is up in the water turns out to be the same colour as whether you're using green or brown. Once the molecules stick to it, it just always looks the same colour to me. But I always do use a fluorocarbon leader in the places that I'm lighting. So, you know.
Well, I do as well because I find that if I use fluorocarbon all the way through, straight onto the reel, I just don't like the way it casts.
No.
I just can't get on with it. And so I use the leader, and I'll use it with, you know, maybe a bit shorter than you're using.
Right.
Especially if I'm doing range.
Yeah.
I don't want so many turns on the reel.
Yeah.
Maybe five or six. Just so long as the bit where the fish are going to encounter me rig and the end bit's okay, I'm happy with that.
Yeah, yeah.
On the continent, I see a lot of the guys using fluorescent green line, oranges, reds. And that's so that when they're going in and out with a boat at night or in the day, they can see the line. And they tend to do that as well. They'll have a clear leader on the end, you know.
Yeah.
So it's not a big issue. But so with zig fishing, let's just consider that for a minute.
Yeah, that's another one. Yeah, I mean,
yeah.
Well, I've actually changed my zig fishing quite dramatically from what I was doing years ago. We used to always go finer line. I actually use fluorocarbon.
Do you?
Just use the fluorocarbon, yeah, because basically what I'm looking at is when the fluorocarbon is, and it even all put heavy mono. I only done it by mistake, really.
Yeah.
Got springy, light line. Right. Just put some fluorocarbon on, because that's all I had. It was 10 or 12 pound fluorocarbon, and 12 pounds it was at the time. Put it out, my hook hole was back here.
You must have some seriously buoyant baits then.
But yeah, there's some good old baits. We were only using 4 foot zigs,
right? Right,
they weren't big zigs.
Yeah.
And yeah, looking at it in the margins when I looked at it clear what you were getting is a bit of effect like that. So my hook holes are further back.
Right.
Where normally zigs you're just catching them here. And then you start losing fish, don't you? I never lost one fish. Mate turned up, borrowed some line off him, lost a load of fish because all here. Went back to me. I think it might have been £10 at the time, but it's £10 fluorocarbon and I was catching them again.
Yeah.
But same again, that's clear. And so,
well, fly anglers, they use fluorocarbon, don't they?
Yeah, they do.
But I look at, say, fluorocarbon, and then look at, say, like a mainline, that's a slightly different, because fluorocarbon's going to sink down, and it's, the light goes through it as such, doesn't it, and so forth. Well, a normal mono, I think it stands out a little bit more clear. That's what I feel.
Yeah.
Definitely when I've looked on the bottom, it just seems to disappear, but I can't get my head around why I've had more takes on the green.
That's an interesting one, isn't it?
And it's not as though it's been just once or twice, it's happening again and again.
That's an interesting one. You'd think, like, fluorocarbon being fluorocarbon, whether, you know, what colour it was, it would virtually disappear anyway.
Disappear, yeah, that's right, yeah. It's things with the fluorocarbon, I get pinned down very quickly. But I mean, I'm fishing at 140, 150 at Grenville. I know for a fact, you know, there's probably 30, 40 yards on the bottom anyway. Yeah. No matter how tight you pull it.
Yeah, you're not going to lift that off, are you?
Lift it off, and it's. And I'll go, hmm. But it just seemed to, for me, from what I've seen, prove to me that the green was going more takes.
Mm. What colour do you use, Frank? Pure leader? Green or clear?
Clear.
Yeah,
that's a fluorocarbonate.
Yeah.
I think if we're using fluorocarbon as a leader, I will go the clear.
Yeah,
we'll go the clear.
Yeah, I just can't see it. Yeah, I always check it in the edge, see how it looks, you know. Just as an aside, I'll tell you a funny one. I was fishing Rainbow, and Hardy turns up, my mate from Holland, and he has gone mad on this sort of weed look stuff, you know.
Yeah.
You get the leaders with all the weed on
effect
it.
On it, yeah.
He's even got his leads. They look like a little furry creature. And he's got it down his hook length, and we were there in January. And he said, oh mate, he said, I must use the weed. I says, there's not a stick of weed in the lake though, mate, at the moment. There's no weed. It's just sand and, you know, gravel. So I got my fluorocarbon leader out, and I had them safe zone leaders as well.
Yeah.
Put it on the bottom, you couldn't see it.
Couldn't see it going.
They were the clear ones. And the lead blended in with the gravel. Everything looked perfect, you know. I laid mine down, and he goes, yeah, but they think mine is weed. All well and good, till he come to wind in. Two of his rods hadn't gone, and the hook had stuck
in
the lead.
The
texture on the lead, yeah. So,
costing fish.
Yeah, it was an expensive little escapade.
I can remember that stuff. I seen you in Italy with him, and he actually showed it to me in Italy.
And
I was looking at it, like, looking at it straight away, you thought, blimey, that's not a bad idea. In the right situation
where it's
that's
going to
work.
Great, it's brilliant.
I'm not sure I'd use it in a lake with no weed at all, though.
No, absolutely not. No.
Be a little bit weird, that
create your own mini features.
That's the one, yeah. Yeah, you could do.
Yeah.